Oh, hello guys, I see you are already here. So I was just checking out the Realme 3 Pro, the brand new Realme 3 Pro guys. I just received it today, so I just thought of making a video today. I just unboxed it few time back, so I just thought of making a video on it. So today I'm gonna talk about the specifications of the brand new Realme 3 Pro. So guys, okay, this is the Realme 3 Pro guys. I'm just joking, this is not the Realme 3 Pro, this is the Note 7 Pro which I bought a month back. But for reference I got this phone of course. But today I'm going to tell you the real specifications of the Realme 3 Pro. So there has been a lot of speculations and talk about the Realme 3 Pro for the past one or two months. The Realme 3 launched and it's on sale now. But the Realme 3 Pro is yet to be launched and it's coming in April. It's gonna be launched around on the second half of April, I suppose. So today I'm going to talk about the real specifications of the Realme 3 Pro. Okay, and I'm going to compare it with the Note 7 Pro, some certain things with the Note 7 Pro. So talking about the Realme 3 Pro, the biggest thing is the processor, of course. As you guys knew when the teaser came out that there was a 3 sign. Okay, so it was something like what's 7 doing in 3. So that the meaning of that was a 7th generation processor or the 700 processor in the phone. So guys, yes, it's true, it is having the Snapdragon 710 and not 712 or something else. It's confirmed that a 710 is gonna be in the Realme 3 Pro. So that's the biggest thing about the Realme 3 Pro. Whereas the Note 7 Pro is having the 675, even though there has been a lot of debate between these two processors, I think so there is not much difference between these two processors. You know, there's some difference between graphics and all that. I don't see a big difference between these two processors because the amplitude benchmarks and other tests don't claim that the 710 is faster than the 675. So there has been a lot of debate, but for now I could say that there's not much difference between these two processors. So coming to the next point, talking about the camera of the Realme 3 Pro, there is not going to be anything of 48 in the Realme 3 Pro and no dual setup. Okay, there is going to be two cameras at the back, of course. Sorry about that. Sorry about the setup. There is going to be a camera for the depth sensor like the 2 Pro, but there is no 48 megapixel stuff going on in the Realme 3 Pro. The main camera is going to be around 25-23 megapixels, and the front camera is going to be around 20 megapixels. So the front camera is obviously going to be better than the Redmi Note 7 Pro, but yes, only thing I can say is that the camera, the main camera which is going to be at the back of the 3 Pro is going to be kind of same as the 48 megapixels on the Redmi Note 7 Pro. Okay, so that way you can be relieved that you always don't need the higher megapixels for a good picture, or maybe to have a good camera you don't really need 48 or maybe a lot of megapixels. 25, 20 should be more than enough for you. Okay, so coming to the fingerprint scanner, as usual it will have the fingerprint scanner at the back and no in-display fingerprint scanner and no pop-up cameras. Okay, so coming to the battery now, the battery is going to be around 4200-4300. Okay, but another big thing which we have in the 3 Pro is the fast charging. Yes guys, 3 Pro is coming with fast charging because as the CEO had said in the launch of the 3 Realme 3 that it is going to be all about speed awakens for the Realme 3 Pro. So it's going to be regarding the speed was regarding the battery and the charging as well. The charging is quick charging, similar something similar which we have in the Oppo phones. So it is going to have a hook charger in the box, which is going to be around 30 watts. But unfortunately, it's not coming with micro USB-C, it's coming with the normal micro USB. So you get micro USB with hook charging and a battery of around 4200 to 4300 mAh. So coming to the display is going to be a, you know, it's going to have Gorilla Glass 3 or maybe 4, and it's a full HD screen just like the Realme 2 Pro, and the size will also be similar to the Realme 2 Pro. And yes, talking about the software of the 3 Pro, we are of course getting Pi out of the box and color 6.0 out of the box. So the software is going to be, you know, better than 2 Pro because of the, you know, latest version. No, not the latest version. Q is already, you know, it's in the development state now. But still, you know, Pi is kind of still you know, up to date version of the OS. So you get Pi and along with ColorOS 6.2. So that is all about the Realme 3 Pro. You can definitely check out the phone when it comes. Of course, I am also eager for the launch in April. So that is about the Realme 3 Pro, guys. This is Anil signing off.